first of all, bravo, Broadway Cruisers, bravo, Bernard Gladstone, I believe we have more songs coming. Okay, so I'm going to be telling a story that have all these songs because, you know, Will Swenson was in Rock of Ages and he did Dead or Alive, and what else did I say? Amiga did Science of Delivered in the show. I'm trying to connect all these songs. Anne Steele sings I Don't Know How to Love, I'm just obsessed with that. Michael Lee had a great song I wanted him to do. And while I'm doing this story, I'm going to sort of leave out certain words, and whoever calls them out first will get a prize. It's going to be certain Broadway words. So we'll start, by the way, we don't have that many prizes, so it'll be like 50% will get a prize. Okay, so here we go. Sorry, I made Greg go buy cheesecake salad, only bought 10. Anywho, here we go. But whoever calls out first will get the first prize. This is going to be the first one. Here we go. We do have magic to do in the form of a story about a girl. A girl who wanted to perform more than anything, but she had problems. Her first problem was her name, Fanny Beagle-Steinovitz. I will indicate. Fanny Beagle-Steinovitz. Not the kind of name people want to see in a marquee. Still, horrific last name or not, she knew she had talent. But no one knew what to make of her. She was like a bagel on a...
Wait about your rules.
I just heard it there. Where was it? Who said it? What? Wasn't it right here? It was all the way over there? Here you go. Ready? One, two, three. First prize. Bagel on a plate full of onion rolls. Excellent. Guys, be quicker with the outtake. She had confidence, and she knew she was born to be the greatest star. Today, Fanny Beagle-Steinovitz.
Listen, I got 36 expressions, sweet as pie and tough as leather. And that's 6 expressions more than all them Barrymores put together. Instead of just kicking me, why don't they give me a lift? You know, it must be a blunt. Cause they're scared that I get such a gift. I'm miffed. Cause I'm the greatest star. I am by far. But no one knows it. Wait, they're gonna hear a voice. A silver flute. They'll cheer each tune. I need a lozenge. When I expose it. Now can't you see to look at me the I just feel I've so much to offer. Yeah, I know I'd be the blind because I'm a natural cougher. Some have got it, not a lump. I'm a great big clump of talent. They'll bend in half, give it up for Seth Rudetsky. Thank you.
Fannie Beal Sinovitz. Okay. So Fannie Beal Sinovitz was determined to make it. She saw they were auditioning for a brand new Broadway show, but the auditions for the role she was right for was scheduled during the afternoon, and she had a day job at the Bonjour...
Trees Beth Grazia Company.
Who the hell was that?
Peter.
Bravo! Very impressive. The Bonjour Trees Beth Grazia Company. What show is that from? Anybody?
Bells are ringing.
Bravo. And into the booth. So she decided to go to the chorus call, which was being held in the evening. Yes, the audition notice specified it was for ladies slightly younger than her, but she thought her talent would override the age discrepancy. Okay, let me have everyone line up on stage, please. Everyone auditioning, line up, please. Everybody, open call. Everybody line up. Everybody line up. Okay, actual line. I mean, shoulder to shoulder. Shoulder to shoulder. Okay. Okay, sell it for a second. Will the following people please step forward? Fannie Beal Sinovitz. Front line, thank you very much. Everyone else, let's please run the number. Is dead. went into a full depression and became determined to marry the next man she met. That night, she went to a bar and declared, "I'm just a girl."
This is no!
That's correct. Lots of men approached her, but they were all too shy to make the first move. She asked them in no uncertain terms for a little less conversation and a little more action, with the help of three backup singers. Take a fan here.
Should I speak of love? Let my feelings
Annie wasn't good at doing domestic chores. She would mix colors with whites, and the whites would come out purple and white and pink and orange and...
blue!
Very good. No price. Excellent! Don't have enough! That was from Joseph, by the way. By the way, on a side note, you know, Yvonne Elliman sang that song, Jesus Christ Superstar. But as far as I know, it was the only Broadway hit past the 70s that was number one twice. First with Yvonne Elliman, then with Helen Reddy. Interesting factoid. Anywho. So Fanny Beetle Steinovitz's only friend was her next door neighbor, Michael Lee. That's not an American name. He was a stay-at-home dad. One day he confessed he had taken dance lessons since he was four. She was like, you're not dancing. God, you're a dancer. A dancer?
There it is.
Excellent. She said, if I'm not going to be a Broadway star, you are. But he told her he didn't want to be a Broadway dancer. He secretly wanted a much more specific goal. Fanny asked him, what do you want?
Want? Want? What do I want? Ever since I was a little boy, there's only been one thing I want. I want, I want what every little red-blooded boy in America could want. I want, I want what I had wanted since the first day I learned how to want. I want to be a rockette. I want to dance until dawn. I want to be a rockette. That's what my heart is set upon. I want to be a rockette. I want to hear the crowd roar. I want to know the magic when they scream for more and more and more and more. I never wanted to be somebody's wife. A suburban life seems a pity. I never wanted to be a movie star. I only wanted to be a dancer at Radio City.
She's got to be where her spirit can run free. She's got to find her...
corner
of the sky. Pretty good. She... 10 minutes later. 1 minute sky. She walked out. She thought about the theater. How could she break into Broadway living in Latin America? Suddenly go out to lunch, she saw a mirrored face. Fanny Beetle Steinovitz, fancy meeting you here. She didn't quite remember who he was. Remember? Fanny, I have a locker next to you. You were locker 24602. Who are you? She asked. Who am I? Who am I? Alright, fine. She can get it. You get it. One, two, four, six, oh, one. Yes, it was her old high school classmate, Frederick Casely. He was now a big-time producer, but why was he in a small little country? No one vacationed here. Well, truth be known, he was in hiding for a little while. A big diva named Roxy was recently cast in his show, but during rehearsal, she was so awful, he walked out. She showed up at his apartment with a gun and said, "Oh, Fred.
Nobody walks out on me."
All right, fine, you get it. Where's Anne Ryan King? Over here? One, two. Very impressive, Anne.
Thank you. Just collect.
She tried to shoot him. She missed, and she went out on a lamb. He decided to go into hiding until she was caught. Until then, she wanted him, sung by Will Swenson, with the actual backup people from Rock of Ages on this boat. She wanted him dead. Summer, fall, winter, and spring. All the seasons. She wanted seasons of love. Jesus. Fred held the contract in front of her face, and Anika Larsson will recreate what she said. Oh yeah, with backup singers. The crowd that was still gathered, they kind of thinned out, but they were still supporting her. Here's your contract. Here's Jesus.
And that time I went and said,
Slot machine comes in front of her and she's torn between the slot machine and Jesus. So she was recreating it. Prahlad, you have to imagine her in a nun's outfit, like singing, like fucking out. Okay. Coming to Off Broadway this fall. And who? Yes, Fanny signed the contract. But there was something else Fred wanted to say. Years ago, when they had lockers next to each other, Fred had a terrible itch. Fanny lent him her industrial-sized gold bond powder. He never itched again. He loved that gold bond, but even more than the gold, that kind gesture made him fall in love with Fanny. Yes, ever since that moment, just like the song from Once, he loved her more than gold. Will Swenson. West Side Story.
Music Man.
Okay, you gotta stop.
I'm getting a check.
Who's this yelling over here? Who's the chick? Ready? Am I gonna take out somebody's eye? Specifically my mother's? Good. Excellent, good catch. She played the water balloon game last night. Okay, tell me who won the Tony Award over Barbara Streisand for Funny Girl? Who's that? Excellent. You were 1 second too late. Bravo, in the orange shirt. Ready, one, two, three. Right near the glass. I'm so nervous here. Can you pass this back to the next gentleman? That's pushing it. Okay, hold on. Okay, this is gonna get harder. Who, you know Elaine Stritch, Ladies Who Lunch? Who won the Tony Award over Elaine Stritch for Ladies Who Lunch?
I know, but you don't want me to answer.
I don't want you to answer, sir. Does anybody else know? Okay, you're amazing. Who?
Helen Gallagher!
One from No Money Net over Elaine Stritch. So impressive. Okay, wait. I have one more. Okay. I'll make it a little bit easier. Who was the famous director choreographer married to Gwen Verdon?
Bob Fosse.
Bravo, right there. She still got it. Bob Fosse it is. Catch with Fosse hands. Excellent. Okay. Our final part of the story. So, Fred's profession of love and his amazing guitar playing was enough to convince Fanny to leave Jesus and go to New York City. Did she drive? Did she take a boat? No. As someone told her lately, everyone deserves a... Who's that right there? Who's that? All right, yeah, okay. Everyone deserves a chance to get beamed. Excellent. So she flew to New York. There was only one problem. Her horrific name. Fanny Beatles Sinovitz. Suddenly, Fred had an idea. Think of Cher, Madonna. She should go by one name, Beatlestein. Too long. Beatle, still too long. How about just Beat? No, there was already a girl named Beat in Equity. Well, asked Fred, what about the Beat? She loved it. Now, there was no stopping her. And after the show opened, even the critics said, "You can't stop the beat!"
Keep spinning round and round, and my heart keeps on just beating down.
One more time for everyone in theater fam.
So if that sad moment for the week comes to an end.
Oh. Bummer sad face.
Bummer sad face. It's been a fantastic week, and Greg and I are so appreciative of you guys being a part of our second Broadway cruise. And we have many more exciting trips coming next year, so I'm going to turn it over to Greg and let him talk a little bit about those trips.
All right, now that we have finished this cruise, we're going to tell you about two big cruises for next year in 2014. First of all, in the summer, July 13th, sailing from Fort Lauderdale to the Western Caribbean, we are doing an Our Family Vacations cruise on the Allure of the Seas. It's the largest, world's largest cruise ship. It's going to be amazing. We're probably...
There's Central Park in the middle of the ship.
There is. You can even go surfing. But it's going to be amazing. It's going to be a huge cruise. We will still have Broadway on it. We have Broadway on everything we do. So that'll be July 13th. And then Broadway cruise number 3 is going to sail from New York City October 11th.
Oh, yeah.
We moved it for my people.
These people were very angry.
Yes. We cannot, well, my mother would not be happy if we were sailing on Yom Kippur, so we did move it a week later. It's going to leave from New York, and it's going to do Kelly and I's favorite itinerary. It is going to go to Canada and New England. So Broadway and lobster every single day.
And leaves changing colors. It's really beautiful. It's a beautiful time to sail up there.
And we could not do this cruise without all of the wonderful people that sail with us. I just have to pull out my little cheat sheet notes. First of all, we've been sailing on NCL for the past 10 years, and it's so wonderful that they welcome us in their home every time we come, and we just love this company so much. So let's just give a big hand to everyone. I know you can believe them. And one of the things I've learned about from all my theater friends is, sure, there's the people that are out front that are singing and up front and center, but really, theater doesn't happen with the people behind the scenes. And there's one person in particular from NCL that we just have to do a big shout out, because he just made this week so easy and perfect and lit and the sound and everything we needed. And we just wanted to do a big thank you to Philip from Norwegian Cruise Line. And then just our wonderful, wonderful performers. She's singing tonight, or maybe last night in Napa Valley, but Audra McDonald. Yeah. And Will Swenson. Yeah. Our wonderful piano player, Nate Bucciari. Yeah. It was like, we had three just diva like friends that I was nervous it was going to be sold out every time we had lunch, but Ann, Anika, and Mariah. My BFF, Michael Lee Scott, our guest appearance. Matt Heimer. And I'm getting old now, so now I can refer to the people 20 years younger than me as the boys. So the boys, Kevin and Lil Ryan. Our wonderful, wonderful director this week. So talented and just a loving man, Bernard Gossin. Of course, my beautiful sidekick, Kelly Carpenter. And finally, I'd like to thank probably one of the smartest, most talented, interesting people I know. He's been a friend of mine for over 10 years, Mr. Seth Brodetsky.
Well, by the seashore,
again, Cal and I, just from the bottom of our heart, would like to thank each of you. We are so lucky and blessed to do what we do, and you know, all the trips that we've done over the years, we just meet the most wonderful, wonderful people. Just, you know, every trip is just a trip, a vacation filled with love and friendship. And so thank you from the bottom of our hearts. We love you all. Please stay in touch with us. We're big on Facebook. We love to tweet. So
Tweet us, Facebook us, stay in touch, and enjoy Burn the Floor tonight. We'll see you hopefully next year or somewhere on Broadway. Thanks, everybody.